Welcome to the online class, student. In the last class, we started how to minimize given a Boolean expression using K-map. So today also we are going to see some more problems, how to evaluate a given a Boolean expression using K-map. So let us consider these three problems.
Is equal to x bar y bar z plus x bar y z plus x y z.
So this is today's first problem. Consider second one,
that is f of a comma b comma c comma d is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
This is second one. Consider one more,
that is y is equal to a bar b bar c bar plus a bar b c bar plus a b bar c bar plus a b c bar.
These are the given three Boolean expressions. Now what we have to do means we have to minimize given Boolean expression using K-map. Before going to minimize given Boolean expression, what is the first step? We have to decide whether the given Boolean expression is in SOP form or POS form. So how to identify it means, see, SOP means sum of product, POS means product of sums. Means, see here, all the three Boolean expressions are in SOP form, means SOP form only. SOP means sum of products, means sum of product means given Boolean expression contain min terms. See here, these are what? Min terms. These are what? Min terms. And between all these min term, plus is there, that is addition operator is there. That's why it is called, these three are called sum of product forms. He is going to give SOP form expressions either in this manner or see a second one in this manner. Means in the first problem, he is given directly min terms, sum of product form, product forms. In the second problem, observe here, these M1, M2, M4, M5, M9, M11, M12, M13. These indicate what? These indicate, small m is indicated by min term. I already told in the last class. So here, small m is given means it is clearly understood that terms are min terms. When terms are min term means, given terms are min term means it is SOP form. When given terms are max term means it is POS form. So now given three expressions are in SOP form only. SOP form only, because terms are min terms, and another one is small m is there. Small m indicates min term designation. So third one is also expression contains only min terms. Therefore, all the three are in SOP form only. So given expressions are SOP form expressions. Now we have to follow the procedure to solve these SOP form expressions using K-map means. Last class we discussed, right? How to evaluate, how to minimize given SOP form expressions. So before going to start, I am going to explain briefly how to solve means. First we have to decide whether it contains min terms or not. Yes, of course, these are all the min terms. Therefore, expression will be in SOP form. So how to evaluate this SOP means? First, we have to identify how many variables are there in the given expression. For example, for the first one, three terms, three variables are there. Variable means here, it may be in a variable form or complemented form. It is considered as one only. So x, y, z or x, y, y, or z, considered as same, three variables are there. So with the help of number of variables, it is possible to find how many cells that KMM table contains. So three variables means formula 2 power n, 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2, 8 cells KMM table must be drawn. Afterwards, write one for only those cells which contains these min terms. After placing ones, we have to group adjacent ones. After grouping, we have to, in the grouping also, we have to give preference to octet, quad, pair. Afterwards, if it is not possible octet or quad or pair means, we have to consider single one group. And afterwards, reduce each group. Afterwards, add all the simplified groups result to get minimized Boolean expression. So already we discussed one problem in the last class. Now let us see how to evaluate given SOP form expression using K-map. So first one, F is equal to x bar, y bar, z plus x bar, y z plus x, y, z. This is the given Boolean expression. It contains only min terms. Therefore, we can say that given expression is in SOP form. In the examination, he is going to give solve the given SOP form, or else he is going to simply say solve the Boolean expression using K-map. We have to identify whether it is SOP or POS. Here, one Boolean expression is there. It contains min terms. The same expression is going to be asked by giving min term designations like this. Or, F is equal to summation of M F1 comma F3 comma F7, M1, M3, M7. Why this is? See here, you just forget right now this step. So solution, first we have to find number of variables in the given Boolean expression. Here, given expression contains three variables. Therefore, number of cells in a table is equal to 2 power n is equal to 2 power 3 is equal to 8 cells. It means now we have to draw a K-map table that contain 8 cells. In the last class I said how to draw a two cell table, 8 cell table as well as 16 cell table, right? So draw the table, three variable table means it contains 8 cells. Three variables x, y, z are there. X, y, z. Right? So take first x bar, afterwards x. Means 0, 1. Because mean terms are there. In the mean term, x bar is considered 0, variable is considered 1. Like that, in the top of the table, we have to write gray code 0, 0, 0, 1. 1 1 1 0, right? So 0 0 means this variable y bar z 1 1 means variable y z 1 0 means y z bar, right? And afterwards write the designations. How to write the designation? This is a standard form 0 1 2 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? You just do 4 or 5 problems, then afterwards you are going to, it is possible you people to write designations. No problem if you have any confusion to write designation, means leave it. Of writing cell, what we have to do? We have to place given min terms. Place we have to put 1. That is, consider first mean term x bar, y bar, z. Find the which cell belongs to x bar, y bar, z. See here, x bar means it comes in this row only. X bar, y bar, z. X bar, this is x bar, y bar, z bar. No, x bar, y bar, z. This cell address is x bar, y bar, z. Right? And next, x bar y z, x bar y z. Next third one, x y z. X y z means here it comes, x y z. Right? See here, what I written here? M1, M3, M7. Where you place 1? 1, 3, 7. It means, in the question, he is going to give min terms or he is going to give min term designation directly. You see here, why I written M1, M3, M7 means, see here, this one is placed min term designation 1, this one is placed min term designation 3. This one is placed in min term designation 7. That's why I written M1, M3, M7. So in the exam, he is going to give only min terms or he is going to give min term designations M1, M3, M7. Directly he is going to give min term designation also. No problem, he is going to give min term or min term designation. We have to solve like this one. Okay, so directly he is given min term designation means need not to do all these things, because we have to see maximum min term 7 is there. So 7 means it comes 3 cells, 3 variable table, or else simply mean terms are given means we have to consider number of variables and we have to find number of cells using formula 2 power n. Okay, so now ones are placed in the respective mean term designation or in the respective mean terms, and the next step is we have to make adjacent ones group. While making group, we have to follow rules. That is, we have to first give preference qua octet. That is, combination of 8 ones is possible? No. Next, we have to give preference to quad. That is, combination of 4 ones. It is possible? No. Then we have to see for pair. That is, combination of 2 ones. It is possible. In this manner. Now the single one remains. Suppose we are going to consider it single one group means it is not possible because we have rule. First we have to give octet, quad, pair. If pair is also not possible means then we have to take this as single group. But here pair is possible by considering this one. By considering this one using overlapping allowed rule, right? So two groups are possible. This is group one, that is pair one. This is group two, that is pair two. So now grouping is over. Now we have to consider separate groups and simplify each group to get minimized Boolean expression. So consider first group first. So here group 1 means we have to consider this first group. That is group 1 is equal to, just consider min term where min term of this one. Min term of this one means x bar y bar z. X bar y bar z plus min term of this one means it comes under x bar y z. X bar y z. Right? So now simplify it. Here in these two terms, x bar z is the common factor, right? So what remains? Y bar plus y remains. We know law x plus x bar is equal to 1. Like that, y plus y bar or y bar plus y becomes 1. So therefore, write the reason x bar into z into 1 because law x plus x bar is equal to 1. Now what we get? Final x bar into z. This is the simplified term of group 1. Like that, find the simplified term of group 2. Group 2 is equal to, where is the group 2? This is the group 2. Now consider this group min terms, that is this one, one comes under x bar y z plus this one comes under x y z. So which is the common factor here? Y z is the common factor. So what remains? X bar plus x is remains, that is y into z into 1 because log x plus x bar is equal to 1. So y z into 1 means y z. Right? So what is the answer? Now each groups are simplified to get minimized Boolean expression what we have to do? We have to add all the simplified groups. Therefore, final answer, therefore, y is equal to, you write 1 by 1, while adding all the simplified terms, if repeated terms are there, means we have to leave it. First term is x bar into z, second term is y into z. Suppose third simplified term is also x bar into z, means we have to consider only that one. We have to avoid duplicates. Here both terms simplified answer is different, that's why we have to consider both the simplified terms. Therefore, y is equal to x bar into z plus y into z is the answer. X bar into z plus y into z is the answer. So, like that, we have to minimize given Boolean expression using K-map. While solving such problems, we have to write necessary sentences. It shows what is going on in the problem. Otherwise, we are going to lose marks. Right? For each step, we have to write in brief what is going on in that step. So, this is the first problem solution. Now let us consider second one. F of ABCD is equal to M1, M2, M4, M5, M9, M11, M12, M13. See here, second one, f of ABCD is equal to M1, M2, M4, M5, M9, M11, M12, M13. Here min terms are not given, min term designation is given. Small m indicates min term designation, capital M indicates max term designation. If a min term designation or min terms are given, means it is SOP form, so we have to follow the same procedure. So here what we have to do is, one variable means 2 power 1, 2 cells. 2 variable means 2 power 2, 4 cells. 3 variable means 2 power 3, 8 cells. 4 variable means 2 power 4 is equal to 16 cells table. We have to draw, I said this thing in last topic, last class. So see here, 16, 4 variables are means 16 cell table we have to draw. Means 16 minimum designations are possible. Means 16 means min term start 0, so it takes maximum M0 to M15. Observe here, M13 is there. M13 is there means it comes under 4 variable. 4 variable means 16 cell table we have to draw. Otherwise, by seeing this midterm designation, or else we have to see here A, B, C, D, 4 variables are there. 4 variables means we have to draw 16 tables. Or midterm designation maximum is M13. M13 means nearer to 16 cells. Right? So that's why what we have to do, solution. Draw the 4 variable. That is 2 power 4 is equal to 16 cells. K map table. That is 16 cells K map table. How to draw?
A, B, C, D.
See here, while drawing 16 cells schema table, we have to consider those variables which are given in the expression. Here A, B, C, D are there. We have to take to draw the table A, B, C, D only. Suppose there X, Y, Z, W is there, means we have to track here X, Y, Z, W only. Right? Or M, N, O, P means we have to take M, N, O, P variable only. So now A, B, C, D are there. So here 16 cell means like this. We have to draw table. So how to write the designations? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11, 6, 7. Leave one row now. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So in the last class, I with the example explained how to write these mean-term designations. Now I am going to explain one more time how I written here mean-term designation. 15 means this cell mean-term is A, B, C. C and O means. So write the gray code like this: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So here, 0 means complement of variable. Variable, 1 means variable. 0, 0 means complement of variable. We have to take this side AB, this side CD. So it becomes A bar, B bar, A bar, B, A, B, A, B bar. So here 0, 0 means C bar, B bar, C bar, D, C, D, C, D bar. Right? See here, why I written 15? See here, why I written here minterm 15 means this cell address minterm is A, B, C. Now find the minterm of this term, minterm designation for this 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3. That is 1, 2, 4, 8. 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 2. 14, 14 plus 1, 15. Minterm designation of ABCD is M, 15. Therefore, I written this cell address as 15. Right? I explained already in the last class. Therefore, I written here 15. Okay. Now, let it be. Now, 16 cell KMF table is over. Now next step is minterm designations are there. So in the respective minterm designation place ones. M1 is there. Where is M1? Here. So place 1. M2. Where is 2? Here. 1. M4. 1. M5. 1. M9. M11. M9. M11. M12, M13, M12, M13, right? See here, we have checked after completing stuff, verify that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 midterm designations are there, therefore 8 ones we have to put, count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 respective minterm designations are there. Therefore, we have to put 8 ones in the respective minterm designation. Now, make the grouping. While grouping, we have to give preference to first octet. Next, we have to give preference to quad. Next, we have to give preference to pair. If all these three is not possible, means we have to give preference to single ones. Now see here, combination of 8 ones is not there, adjacent 8 ones are not there. So here search for quad. Here what quad is possible, right?
Group 1 quad 1,
right? Octet is not possible, that's why go for grouping of 4 ones, that is quad. One quad is possible, and observe here 1, 2, 3, 4, one more quad is possible. Consider this quad, and this is
group 2.
It is also called group 2, means quad 2. Quad 2. Now the you leave these things, the remaining means this one and this one, this cell and this cell. Now this is going to be overlap with this. Don't go for single ones grouping, because here overlapping is allowed. If we are going to combine with this one, means by using overlapping rule, means it becomes pair. We have to give preference to pair. If pair is not possible, we have to go for single ones. So group this one using overlapping method rule, then this is called group 3, that is pair 1. Now the remaining one is this one. This is not going to be combined with this one, because what the rule says, top cell column 1, top cell is grouped with bottom column 1 of the bottom cell. Here one is not there, and one more rule, leftmost in a row, leftmost cell is grouped with rightmost cell of the row. So here one is there, but here one is not there. So don't combine with this one, because this is not leftmost one of a row. Therefore, for this one, pair is not possible. Consider this as single one. This is called group 4, that is single. Now to get simplified K-map, simplified Boolean expression, we have to minimize all these four groups, and to get final answer, we have to add all the minimized terms of the group. Now solve each group, that is consider first one,
group 1 is equal to, group 1 means this quad, right? So take min terms of each one, then we get this one min term is A bar B, C bar D bar, plus this one means A B C bar D bar, A B C bar D bar, plus this one A bar B C bar D, plus this one A B C bar D, right?
So see here, what I consider means this is one quad, right? So now we have to consider these four ones min terms. This one comes under A bar B C bar D, A bar B C bar D bar, plus this one comes under A B C bar D, A B C bar D, plus this one comes under A bar B C bar D, A bar B C bar D, plus this one comes under AB C bar. AB C bar D. Now, what is the common factor in these two terms? B C bar D bar is there. So B C bar D bar, A is the common factor. A bar plus, A remains A bar plus A plus here. What is the common factor? B C bar D. B C bar D. So what remains here? A bar plus A remains. So A bar plus A means 1. A plus A bar or A bar plus A means 1, because law x plus x bar equal to 1. So what remains here? B C bar D bar into 1 means B C bar D bar plus B C bar D. Here what is the common factor? B C bar is the common factor. B C bar is the common factor. After taking B C bar, what is the remaining thing? D bar plus D. D bar plus D means 1. B into C bar into 1 means we get B into C bar. This is the simplified term of group 1. So like that, consider group 2. That is, group 2 means this one. This quad, second quad, that is, this one comes under A bar, B bar, C bar, D plus this one comes under A bar, B, C bar, D plus this one comes under A, B, C bar, D plus this one comes under A, B bar, C bar, D. C bar, D. So see here, in these two terms, what is the common factor? A bar, C bar, D is the common factor. A bar, B bar, sorry, A bar, C bar, plus C bar, D is the common factor. Remaining thing, B bar plus B plus in these two terms, what is the common factor? A C bar D, A C bar B, remaining B plus B bar. Here also B plus B bar means x plus x bar can be written as 1. Therefore A bar C bar D into 1 means we get A bar C bar D plus here also A into C bar into D into 1 means we get A into C bar into D. Now what is the common factor between these two terms? C bar D is the common factor. What remains? A bar plus A remains. A bar plus A means 1. That is law x plus x bar equal to 1. So c bar d into 1 means we get c bar d is the minimizer term. Like that, group 1 is over, group 2 is over. Now consider group 3. Group 3, that is pair. This pair, group 3. Right, group 3 is there. So consider this one comes under its minterm designation is A into B bar, A into B bar, C bar D plus A into B bar C. So what is the common factor here? A into B bar into B
D is the common factor. A into B bar into D is the common factor. So remains C bar plus C. So we get answer A into B bar into D. Because C plus C bar is 1. And next, consider group 4. Group 4 is equal to group 4 is equal to the simple one. So what we get? A bar B bar C into B bar. C into B bar. Only one term is there. This one comes under A bar B bar C into D bar.
Only one term is there. So only one term is there means that simplification is not possible. Now,
what?
Simplification of all the four roots are over. Now, add all the simplified four groups to get minimized Boolean expression.
That is what we get. That is, therefore, write one line.
To get minimized the Boolean expression, add all the simplified terms and eliminate the repeated terms.
See here, first term B into C bar is there. Second term C bar into D is there. Third term A into B bar into D is there. Fourth term A bar into B bar into C into
D bar is there.
So all the terms are different. Nothing is repeated.
Hence consider all the terms.
Then we get Y is equal to first term B into C bar plus second term C bar into D. Second simplified term C bar into D. Third one A into B bar into B, A into B bar into B, plus fourth term as it is, A bar into B bar into C, B bar, C, B bar.
See what is happening? So to get a minimized Boolean expression, add all the given simplified terms to get minimized Boolean expression. So this is nothing but final result. This is nothing but final result. Like that, we have to simplify given Boolean expression using K-map method. So the last class as well as this class, we simplified given Boolean expression which are in SOP form, right? So in the next class we are going to discuss simplify given POS form expressions using K-map. For POS expression, slight different method is there. We are going to discuss in the next class. Thank you.